graphic nature of this program, listener discretion is advised.
Give me your gun.
What's going on over there?
Put the gun down.
I saw you with the box. What was in the box?
Because I envy your normal life.
Put the gun down, David.
It seems that envy is my sin.
No, what's in the box?
Not until you give me the
what's
gun.
What's in the fucking box?
Give me the gun.
He just told you.
You lie! You're a fucking liar! Shut up!
That's what he wants. He wants you to shoot him.
No! No! You tell me that's not true. That's not true.
Become vengeance, dude.
Oh, she's all right. You tell me.
Become wrath.
It's just a coincidence that you were talking about the Jack and Triumph show, and I'm here. Thank you so much for having me on your podcast.
Hey, man, this is Kevin Smith, guy who makes all those unlistenable podcasts over at Smodcast.com, and you're listening to the Two Strangers, One Podcast. This is podcasting.
You're listening to Two Strangers, One Podcast. Subscribe to us on iTunes or on the Stitcher app for Android devices. Please visit TwoStrangersOnePodcast.net. Now, here's Chris Colone and Paul Pasquillo.
Well, hello and welcome to Two Strangers, One Podcast. I'm Chris.
I'm Paul.
And Paul, where's the trigger? Where's the trigger? Where's, I don't know why. I've been,
that's like you're like lying.
I've been screaming that. Well, one, I'm all hopped up on caffeine, as I say in every episode, which
you're
I am.
Out, you're hopped up on caffeine, breadsticks, and Mountain Dew.
Mountain Dew. The caffeine's from the Mountain Dew. What is it, Pizza Hut? We had Pizza Hut pizza today. Not that that's an endorsement or anything like that. But
not that you shouldn't sponsor us, Pizza Hut.
This is not a paid endorsement, unless you'd like it to be Pizza Hut. I mean, we do watch our live stream. We're reaching out to a whole bunch of people, so. I'm letting people know, please, if you're going to watch, I mean, not please.
Faithful, it's fine. Forget him. You can come and sponsor my stuff.
Well, no, I'm telling him, no, watch it. We have people watching us. Feel free to interact. Feel free to ask us any questions. You know, because like I've been watching a couple of live streams. Now that we've been live streaming.
I'm not Wilson anymore. Hi, people.
Let me, I keep the microphone down. It's on like a kid's blanket because when I bang the table. Usually I hit the table without realizing I'm hitting
the table.
Why do
you like to bang the table? Dude,
it's been a long time.
This was an expensive table.
I haven't gotten laid since last year around my birthday.
Do not bang the table.
So when the table gets banged, it picks up on the mic, so I have to put this little cushion here.
How hard do you bang it?
Well, you know, I haven't gotten pregnant yet. But,
oh, God.
So I've been screaming. Ever since we got down to the basement, I've been screaming, where's the trigger? Where's the trigger? Where is it? Hey, Jen. Once again, just feel free to ask us anything. We were on the air. Thank you for as interactive as you were the last episode. And actually, now that I see Jen, I got to remember to bring up.
Oscar sent us another.
Oscar sent us another long one.
What the hell is that?
And this is really, really, really.
Did he send one? Does it involve
should,
me?
Should we start the episode? Should we start the episode with an Oscar letter?
Sure, why
right
not?
In the beginning?
Why not? Whatever.
Okay, Chris. And once again, I haven't read this. I literally brought this up right now. Oh, and Jen says, hey, guys. Okay, Oscar, super fan. Chris, I have to say that I'm very disappointed in you. After being the show's number one fan, you have the audacity to censor me. Well, it's just, okay, I'm glad he brought it up because it's just... You know what? Feel free to bash me as much as you like.
Wait a minute. You have no right to be the number one fan when you leave for like months on end and then come back and
He was he was shuffling through fucking earthquake rubble.
Did he say that?
He didn't say that. He had to wait for, you know, whatever the Chilean equivalent of the we should make fun of fucking natural disasters. But you know, you had to wait for the Wi-Fi, you know, the internet to be set back up. They had to put the towers back up and stuff like that. You know, the cell phone towers or whatever. However they get internet over there.
I mean, the first thing that he listened to. Oh, it looks like Jen said something.
Oh, okay. Okay. Oh, okay. So all right. So Jen wants to know what he said. I'd rather not address it. If you want to address it on the show, I'll address it on the show. But he was kind of being rude to you. And that's the whole thing. Like, I wanted to say, Oscar, feel free to bash me all you like. And, you know, and I guess Paul's kind of like the same way. I'm pretty sure Paul isn't going to be like, his earth isn't going to shatter if you insult him also. But I just felt like I just wanted to censor him.
It's not going to shatter, but Oscar's bones may shatter when I Cinderella after him. I mean, I does.
But it's just, I just, you know, I don't want him to. I don't insult other people that aren't involved with the show. Oh, okay. Jen says may as well. And of course, the minute we record, the freaking cat's gonna come up on the. And this is Paul's cat looking right into the camera, and. I don't know, this may eventually become my cat, because...
It probably will eventually
become Paul can't take care of her anymore. Not that he can't take care of her, but...
I have another cat.
He has two jobs, two podcasts, two cats. He's got to get rid of one of them, so Paul's finally going to give me some pussy. no, but seriously, I may adopt this lovely little creature that just came to the screen.
She will always still be mine, though, just so you know.
Well, you're going to babysit when I got on vacation. And
of course.
Paul, I'm going down to New York City for a couple of weeks, which we'll get to that in a second. Okay.
So read this email.
I addressed this because I know Paul doesn't read or screen the emails to the show. He's too busy with that horrid tsunami stuff.
I swear to God, I'll kill you, Oscar.
Paul, I'm sorry. I really tried to listen to the podcast to get me the fix, as this fucking show is so sporadic in its frequency. But not even the soothing sounds of you or the pistol-packing Urkel are enough to keep me tuned to a show that I couldn't give a fuck about. And let me tell you, in all fairness, I haven't listened to the podcast. I haven't listened to Toonami Faithful in a couple weeks, and I'm not going to lie about that. But I do listen to it because at least I feel like it catches me up on stuff that I should know. Like, I see internet memes about One Punch Man, but I guess I can watch it now. Or you know, what's the other one?
Oh, we do a good job of describing it, that's for sure.
You know, the Iron Orphans or some shit. Like, what's the Iron Orphans?
Iron Blood Orphan,
it's something Gundam. Or other. Oh, okay. M. Brown's watching. That's my daughter's grandmother. I am. So, once again, feel free to ask us anything. Like I put right in the description. So like I was saying, I actually listen to the Tommy Faithful. Like I said, I'm not going to lie and say I listen to it all the time. But when I do...
You should listen to it all the time.
I should. But I download it. I mean, my Stitcher automatically gets it. So at least you guys get the download numbers.
Like, oh, we get a lot of... We get really good numbers. So we probably do... Well, I don't want
to... Oh, which... Wait, it's going to take us forever to get to this letter. But let me tell you,
Don't worry about me. I'm just sitting here pitting.
This show is going to be switching. We're going to leave. We're going to be leaving our provider. M. Brown says, "Hi, Chris. Not sure what this is about. Just wanted to say hi. You know, I've been doing this podcast thing for about 4 years now. Just sort of, you know, hanging out with my buddy Paul, and before him, we had another co-host named Kristen, and it's just sort of my way of just venting. It gives me a reason to socialize, get out of the house, and do stuff and have total strangers from around the world insult me. So,
wait, should this episode be called Two Strangers, One Pussy?
Two Strangers, One Pussy? We can't call it Where's the Trigger because we actually have an episode. We already have an episode called Where's the Trigger.
Where's the Trigger?
Where is it? But, no, okay, so we our usual podcast host server site is called Podomatic.
Yeah.
And... it renews in the beginning of October, or we're due to be renewed in the beginning of October, and
you better start moving that shit over if you're doing that.
Well, no, that's the whole thing. Is that I said, okay, you know, right now, you know, I've been able to take care of my bills. I don't want to say ahead of time, but you know, this particular month has three paydays in it, and I'm like, okay, I can pay the bill now. I didn't want to. I know it's a little bit more than usual, but I was like. For the fucking headache that it's going to cause me, let me renew the server fees now. And I contact them. Oh, we can't do an automatic renewal. And the guy goes, if you like, if you absolutely want to pay now, you can cancel your subscription and start up again. And lose a month, you know, for what I'm paying for. And then, because now mind you, there's 50,000 buttons on the page to upgrade. If I want to upgrade our service and how much space we have and how much bandwidth. And right now, okay, yes, I do have to delete old episodes because, you know, to make space for the new ones. But honestly, unless you're like a super duper fan, who's listening to episodes from 4 years ago, 3 years ago? And if not, you could always go on YouTube and find them because I upload them as videos. And so, you know, okay, yeah, 50,000 buttons to upgrade the service. And I could upgrade now, I'll get 2 months free. And... so I'm pissed off because they're like, I have to wait to the beginning of October, which is when you know, we'll bring this up later. New York Comic Con starts, which is what happened last year. Right. Last year, I had a couple of bucks to bring with me to New York Comic Con, and they wiped out my fucking account with that. With paying, you know, paying the Podomatic bill wiped me out, which left me with like no budget of like jerk off money for New York Comic Con. That's what it is. Look, when you go out and buy comics and stuff like that. Look, I don't have many vices. I don't drink. I don't do drugs. I don't smoke cigarettes anymore. Not really. I'm too broke to smoke cigarettes. You know, my two fucking vices are like, you know, dumb comic book shit and caffeine and this podcast. So we may be experiencing some sort of move over to SoundCloud in the eventual future. So just putting that out there because
about time.
Podomatic is there. You know, I've been a loyal, obviously with the show going on 4 years now. I've been a loyal customer for 4 years. It shouldn't be that fucking hard, you know. And I was like, do I have to? Maybe I could call somebody. It doesn't, you know, I can send.
There should be a 1-800 number.
And no, I'm saying, but like I contacted them on their site, and they got back to me. But it's like, you know, can I just call? Can you just charge my card now? You know what I'm saying? Like, you know,
yeah.
Charge it now because I'm not gonna have the money. I'm not gonna have the money. Something's gonna come up. My fucking car's gonna explode or something. I know something like that's gonna happen. So, it is what it is. So I'm kind of pissed off about that. Okay, back to Oscar's letter.
Yeah, it's about time. Okay,
I really wish you guys would add a wrestling segment to your show. I didn't. We were talking about how much wrestling sucks.
Well, we do talk about wrestling every once in a while.
On occasion. I know you brought it up before, but it can't be realistically done as Chris is so broke he can't pay attention or for damn Wi-Fi. I tried listening to your friend's Big Ray's wrestling podcast, and I was intrigued for a few episodes. Because he had a chick on it. However, she is gone. Although Ray's voice is somewhat appealing to the ear, the show isn't that good. Wow. Sam Roberts and Pete Rosenberg, Cheap Heat, have nothing to worry about. Ray's show isn't that good. now he's bashing Ray, but okay. So I guess, okay. All right, have a good night, M. She's saying, they have no idea what this is about. It's just us talking about nerdy stuff, talking about the first half of the show. Traditionally, we talk about stuff going on in our lives, stuff like this, about the podcast. Then the second half of the show, then it gets really nerdy, you know, superhero movies.
Throughout the podcast, I stroke my like.
Oh, yeah. Paul's doing his Dr. Evil impression back there. Oh, okay. So.
It does actually work because it's a white cat, so there you go.
Okay, so Ray's, and yes, I was bashing Ray, but yes. I have to admit it, I did enjoy him thoroughly on Two Strangers, One Podcast. Chris, see if you can get a second job, like the younger and more appealing Paul. He has two jobs, why don't you? Paul helps school your older co-host. Well, I'm waiting for, you know, where I was waiting for Uber, like, to come to Rochester. Like, that was sort of, I kind of wanted, I've been seriously, I mean, I think we had Lyft up here.
So what happened was, is
they met. I'm not sure, met
I'm not
the
sure
mayor.
If they're in Buffalo.
They met with the mayor here in Rochester.
Well, okay,
so I'm pretty sure they kind of slid
much,
a couple dollars under the table, you know, as
pretty
a,
much
on
what,
video
what's going
under the
okay,
table.
Okay. Stop trying to bang the table. I told you it was free, but you can't bang the table.
Where's the trigger?
So basically, they have to change some kind of law in the assembly, in New York State Assembly. Mm-hmm. So they haven't done that at all, and until that happens, Lyft and Uber can't come into Rochester. They actually, it was really weird because I don't think it was Uber. Uber was here, and then
I could have sworn Lyft was up here, but now isn't.
It was one of them. It was one of them that was up here, but then it was like, I don't know. It went, and what did they say?
So Jen says, okay, Jen, okay, thank you, Jen. Thank you for confirming what I just said.
What?
That she said Lyft was here. And she said, and a deal to be allowed to go to NYC, the state took them out of upstate New York. Oh, so I guess,
yeah.
You know, they kind of gave up the rest of the state for New York City. And I'm just thinking is that, you know, I used to work off of, you know, I used to work on Monroe Avenue. There's a lot of young people drinking, you know, this is a college town. Young people use their phones for everything.
I don't think it's just
so
that.
Why not,
I think,
you know,
it's...
why not use, you know, be a Lyft, Uber driver. And then plus, I mean, that's a kind of like, you know, I do live relatively close to the airport, so like I probably get a lot of people from out of town, like, you know, picking people up from the airport and shit like that.
Well, I mean, yeah, that's basically like, okay, so let's say like people were coming in for a con, like if Flower City Comic Con, for example, becomes big, mm-hmm. you know, maybe people would come out from like Buffalo or whatever, and then, you know, you can get people and whatnot. So, you know, that would be good. You know, you could pick them up from the bus station and whatnot.
If I have another job, it has to be a flexible job. It has to be a job I could do at night. Has to be flexible. I go to Lyle Avenue and sell my ass.
Actually, what it would be good for is what I noticed is a lot of people from RIT mm-hmm. that are coming from wherever were using it because, you know, they don't have a vehicle, they can't, whatever.
That's what I'm saying. This is a young person's town, and you would think
we get a lot of foreigners. You would be surprised.
No, but I'm just saying, it's young people who use the phones. They use their phone for everything else. Why not Uber? And so it's not that I haven't looked into other jobs. But I think Uber would be perfect for me.
Well,
I just don't want to get hit in the fucking head.
I mean, I have two jobs, but like
I don't want to be held up.
I also do other things on the side, so that I'm making extra money. But you know, I do manage a nerdcore artist for God's sake. So, you know, I am.
And I'm the lazy bum with just one job.
So I do some other things, but money is money. You need to get more money. So you gotta get that Wi-Fi back so I don't have to hear pistol packing Urkel bitch anymore. Oh, I want to be on the podcast. Well, it's not my fault.
Oh, Darrell wants to be on the podcast?
Well, he's always been saying
that. Okay, so we will, I promise you, we'll get Darrell in the next couple episodes. And Jen, we'll get you. Okay, so he says, I got a chance to see the video of the Facebook. But not Lepris, that beard is so fucking horrid. You look exactly like the hipsters that you complain so much about gentrifying NYC. I swear that you must grow that thing to be ironic. It's one thing to be fat, but why voluntarily make yourself look like a beast? God. Wearing a beard so long and tattered that you look like a feral cat on the street. Is a beard an homage to Anakin? That's right, I'm a super fan. I know all he remembers my cat.
We just gotta get you a Jedi uniform, and I think we're good.
No, you know what happened was...
You will listen to Two Strangers, One Podcast.
You will tell your friends. You will tell your friends about Two Strangers, One Podcast. You know what it was? For 10 years, I was a correction officer. And for 10 years, we didn't have to be clean-shaven, but they kind of made it... You couldn't grow a goatee. You could only grow, like, a mustache.
Sir, I did see you. I've seen several pictures of you on Facebook where you're like, you have hair,
Well, I used to grow my goatee... Until like a supervisor said something, yeah, and they would be like, because their argument was with the state was, if you ever have to wear a gas mask, the gas mask, because I trained in chemical agents. I trained in how to use like the gun that shoots the containers of gas. I've been sprayed in the face with mace, in training that because I was getting frisky, and a few other things. You know, so I've been trained with the gun, and they say if you have a beard, it won't make a seal under your neck, under your chin. Mm-hmm. One, those gas masks are so fucking tight that you can have a beard, and the beard isn't going to make any kind of difference. I mean, a beard like this maybe make a difference, but the goatees that I used to have wouldn't make a difference. And plus, I worked downtown Manhattan, a place called Baby. That was a woman's medium/minimum facility. We're not using chemical agents. There's never going to be a riot inside that. And it's closed now, but, you know, at the time. And then I used to work in a place called Baby, which is also closed. Staten Island, I worked in a place called Arthur Kill, which was also a medium security facility. Once again, they wouldn't be using chemical agents in a facility like that. You know, both those places are closed. And I must be the fucking angel of death because both those facilities are closed. I used to work for Radio Shack. That place is closed. I'm not going to disclose where I work now, but, you know, there's rumors that it's been sold to another company. You know, so I'm just the fucking angel of death. And actually, I've been working in a store that's closing this week, as a matter of fact.
Well, you're getting moved to a different store.
Moved, but I'm just saying, everywhere I go, there's fucking death and destruction.
Well, I'm sure that that's not going to be the only store, too. I mean, we're not going to really talk about what it is, but I mean, I think that your company will end up losing a couple other stores when leases are up.
So. Yeah. All right, so he goes back to my previous statement. Why the fuck was I censored? You're truly wrong. I hereby revoke your censorship in the George Carlin fan club. George would turn in his grave if you knew that you're censoring your number one fan. Fuck you, Chris Colon. Fuck you deep and hard. May a hipster homosexual violate you madly in the back of your place of employment as homeless people walk out with beer without paying and the suburban housewife super coupon their way through your store's bankruptcy. Listen to you speak of that sad mini class reunion made me feel good about my life. As a friend would announce respectable careers, you would unfortunately that you are a retail supervisor. I think the guy that scraped the roadkill off the highway or the guy that empties portable toilets laugh at you. Weren't you a peace officer? Like I just mentioned, yes. Why not try and gang something in that field again, like a dog catcher or a meter maid? Which is actually, they call it traffic enforcement. I've taken a test for that, but it's such a long list. Cousin Evelise is watching. Hello, cousin. Once again, feel free to ask us anything. Okay, damn, you're sad. Hopefully this email will give you a shot in the ass. You need to do a show sooner. I'm so pissed about being censored, Oscar. Sorry for destroying you. I had to come in. The show makes me more happy. Please bring back the Urkel and Ray. Fuck your sensitivity to Jen and Layla. Censor that bitch. Okay, so since Jen asked for it, since Jen said it's okay, I'll find
Oscar. So which Jen are we talking about? The Jen I know or somebody else?
No, the Jen, like in between, after Kristen left, I did a couple of episodes with Jen before you became more of a permanent fixture on the show. And so
that's right, I'm the permanent fixture.
Well, okay.
I'm trying to do the Hulk Hogan on camera, I can't.
Okay, so I'm looking at it right now, and yeah, okay, all right, so Jen wants, okay, so he goes, okay, Chris, and once again, I'm reading this, don't get angry, don't kill the messenger. Jen is fucking horrible, almost as painful as your baby mama Layla, which I do have to admit, when I had my daughter's mother on, she was kind of, but she was, that, it was years, it feels so weird that it was so long ago.
So he must have gone back and listened to some of these.
She was, no, Oscar's been interacting with the show since that long. He didn't go back.
This is just then. That must be random because that wasn't.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So I mean, at the time she was doing drugs. She's clean now. Like I said, I've laid down the arms. We're not fighting anymore for the time being. You know, things are relatively good. You know,
been put in doubt.
At that particular juncture, she was high as a kite when we did the episode. You better not put that snooze fest back on the podcast. Those two chicks were painful to listen to. I know that a horrid beast like yourself finds it almost impossible to get laid, but please don't subject your audience to that pain. And as I remember, Jen didn't even give you a piece of ass and put you in the friend zone immediately. All right, okay, it's the truth, but I'm just saying what he said. Anyway, love to destroy you, Chris. You make it so easily. Thank you for making me feel good about my life. So, okay, I guess maybe it wasn't as bad. I just don't want, like, don't attack my friends. Don't attack, you know. Like I said, you're on the show, and you're sitting here right now to defend yourself, so you can, you know, Jen. I mean, I guess, so, you know, if she wants to respond, she can respond. Jen, if you want to say anything, I will gladly repeat anything you say.
I mean, that wasn't really that bad, but okay.
Oh no, no, oh so, no, and Jen wants to clarify. No, no, clarify who was high when recording. No, because I guess on different episodes, I had my daughter's mother, and I think that was sort of the end. I think having my daughter's mother on was one of the straws that broke the camel's back when Kristen wanted to leave, because Kristen got like so mad at me. But in all fairness, like Kristen and I were supposed to do like an episode, and she canceled on me like twice, and I wanted to get an episode out bad. So I'm like, my daughter's mother was there. I said, let's do an episode. Unfortunately, that was at a different time in her life where she was kind of fucked up or whatever. We did an episode together, and you know. It's a horrible episode. It's not a good episode. You know, talking to someone that's high is not probably the best form of entertainment. But I wanted to put an episode out, and I know that pissed Kristen off. And so when we're talking about, hey Danny, how you doing? So what I was saying is that, you know, that the episode I did with my baby mama, not the best episode, and that's how far back Oscar goes, back, you know,
before, yeah, really,
Oscar's been with the show longer than you, Paul. But,
jeez.
You know, but, you know, I just, like I said, don't,
by the way,
I don't
where
want
the fuck
him
is
defending.
My Two Strangers, One Podcast shirt?
I'll get you one. I got
it. Yeah, extra large, motherfucker. Well, no, I want it white.
I made my Two Strangers on the Podcast shirt, so I have to go. I'll go to Walmart. I'll get the. No, no making it.
I want you to go in. I want you to go on Redbubble. Get me one for $25.
Well, I'll go. Well, you know, I should. I got to do one. Maybe I should go to Zazzle. Zazzle was a, when I made shirts my size, and okay, Jen. Okay, so Jen says, and this is Jen's response. As for the recording, I agree because we were too connected at that point. And we were talking about shit like friends, not strangers. And I guess, yeah. I mean, at the time, I don't know. It feels weird talking about this, like, well, Jen right here, right in front of the microphone. But yeah, it was, our relationship was different at that time. And, you know, was it awkward? I mean, it might have been awkward. I mean, I enjoyed it. I love every single episode. I'll admit if a show sucks or not, but maybe it's just because I love hearing the sound of my voice. I don't know.
Well, I do love to hear the sound of my voice.
And, you know, someone said I could talk, like, I swear there's like a review for the podcast that, like, I could talk to a stalk of celery and make it interesting. But,
I mean, don't do that, but yes, you probably could.
We wasted, we spent the first half an hour of the show just talking about, I still have tons of stuff to talk about here. Well, I don't have much nerdy stuff, so I guess we could kind of get into that. Okay, so I guess we'll be back. All right, so on the recording part, we'll be back. And for those streaming at home, just stay with us. We'll be back with more dick and fart jokes.
This episode of Two Strangers, One Podcast is brought to you by Comics Etc., 1115 East Main and North Goodman at the Hungerford Building, door number 8. Find out more information at comicsetc.biz or like them on Facebook at facebook.com/comicsetc1.
Click and Hit, enhancing the experience for all recreational smokers. Click and Hit is a one-handed portable vaporizer. This smoking pipe has a compact four-stage design, complete with a built-in windproof butane refillable torch lighter. The large burn chamber holds your stash of legal herb or pipe tobacco. Click the button to ignite and inhale as usual. When you are done, put it back in your pocket for later. Smoke anytime with the touch of a button. No more carrying around grinders and tins. You can leave the pipe, rolling papers, and even your lighter at home. The Click and Hit cordless vaporizer is no bigger than a normal cigar, making it the world's smallest and most discreet vaporizer. It's perfect for use in small places or shared rooms. It's efficient, getting 5 to 8 draws from your packed chamber. It's affordable at just $19.95 each. Buy 3 and the shipping is free. Buy 4 and you get the 5th one free. Visit www.click-hit.com. That's clickandhit.com.
And now for listeners of Two Strangers, One Podcast, you can use promo code STRANGERS and receive 10% off your purchase at clickandhit.com. That's promo code STRANGERS for 10% off your purchase.
And we're back. See how easy that is? So we still have real life stuff to talk about. Real life stuff. This is my last week at the store that I was sent to like a month ago, to be told that they're shutting down. A week ago, we went to 50% off, and the fucking coupon-clipping old ladies lost their fucking mind. Came to start buying cartloads of stuff, and then, so that lasted for a week. Then we went to 75% off, and the same women, I saw the same people 2 or 3 times a day.
Jesus.
You know, filling up the cart, people spending, you know, when you add, I'm like doing the math and I'm like, this woman spent $700 today on shit that they don't need. And I understand this is a place where I work, but, you know, I guess, I mean, don't get me wrong. When you see 75% off, you kind of like, I don't need it right now, but I'll buy it just to, I bought my daughter like hair lice medicine. Because unfortunately, when she was in kindergarten or pre-kindergarten, whatever, she went to school and
she get from the city.
A kid gave my daughter head lice. So I bought head lice medicine. You know, in case I need it, I'm good for the season. you know, bought condoms. Not like I'm gonna fucking need them, but I bought condoms, you know, little odds and ends and stuff like that. But the women were just coming in buying all types of useless shit, you know, just because of 75% off. And, you know, you could take a lump of shit, charge $10 for it, and they say, you know what, we'll slash it down to 75% off, and it's $2.50 for this lump of shit. Someone will feel inclined to buy it, because who knows, someone else may come in and buy that lump of shit for $2.50. So it's just been, it's been a fucking nightmare, you know, when it comes to just, you know, people coming in. And, you know, if something goes wrong, then you got a line building up, and people get angry and irritated. And it's like, is your time worth all that money? You know, if you're saving such and such, you know, when you're clipping coupons and stuff like that, is it worth you standing in line behind a bunch of other people to buy shit that you don't need, behind other people who buy shit that they don't fucking need, you know? And like I said, I say that, yes, it's the store they work at, but, you know, come on, people. No one watches this show anyway. Lice happens. Yeah, lice does happen. It's, you know, and I guess maybe because I'm a boy, I never had lice or whatever, and my daughter had it. And my daughter, you know, half Native American, thick Native American hair, you know, fucking, you know. And I never dealt with lice before my daughter. I never, you know, I never knew what to look for. I never knew. All I know is she was scratching her head, and I didn't know what the fuck was going on. Then they called me from the school and said, you got to come get your daughter. And it's embarrassing, because it makes you feel like you're a bad fucking parent. And it's not you, it's some other kid brought it in. Because then when I got there, they're like, oh, some other kid had it. You know, and then they make me feel bad, you know. So, you know, just having issues with my boss. I can't wait. I'm like 2-3 more days. I don't have to deal with this guy anymore. And I just have to say, look, just because someone puts you in charge doesn't make you a leader. You know what I'm saying? Like, you know, someone can say, run this store. And yeah, you can do all the paperwork that needs to run the store. You can make sure the deposits are made. You can make sure that the drawers are balanced. That doesn't make you a leader. That doesn't make you good with people. That doesn't make you a person that inspires leadership. You know, there's a book called, not that I didn't, I started reading, there's a book called Leaders Eat Last. You know, where, you know, you got to put your employees before yourself.
Right.
You know, I understand, and, you know, don't get me wrong, I understand there are employees out there who will take advantage of you, and there are employees, you know, if they find out you're a nice guy, people will say, like, oh, you know, don't mistake my kindness for weakness. Oh, yeah, I saw that. It's sad that I already saw that. Paul's showing me a picture of the Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D.
It came out today, I think.
Is it today?
Yeah. Not the first episode.
The pictures came out today.
Yeah.
Yeah, most shows, they wait till like late fucking September before they start showing. I think they do it on purpose.
Well, like all the DC shows that are on CW don't come out until October, so.
Yeah. So, well, I guess we'll save that for the nerdy part of the show. But, yeah, I'm just fucking pissed at my boss. Like, you know, dude, someone put you in charge. You're not a fucking leader. My beard has been with the company longer than you have. And, you know, I remember the guy they hired before him. Well, unfortunately, that guy didn't work out because he had kidney failure and all that shit. They needed someone to fill a fucking hole. And in the 2-3 years this guy's been with the company, he hasn't developed any fucking leadership skills. And, you know, it bothers me. You know, am I a lazy fuck and I'm late all the time for work? Yes, that's my issues. You know, and you know, I do act like I don't give a
You're
fuck.
You're late for work? No.
Yeah.
No.
Yeah, I haven't been late for work while I'm recording this podcast. Okay. Oh, so Jen says, so Danny says they had lice, you know, every other week it goes to clean hair. And then Jen says, we get one lice litter home a year about some kid outbreak. Not your fault. And then thank you, and I appreciate it. You know, parents, I guess we're all commiserated under the same bullshit. You know, lice happens. But yeah, I can't wait to get out of that fucking store with that guy. Because what happened was Saturday, we were supposed to have, it was me, a cashier, and we're supposed to have a third cashier, a third person in the store. The person didn't show up. I called my boss. Oh, well, she didn't show up yesterday, and I guess she didn't show up today. And so I'm like, oh, she didn't. I didn't know she was scheduled the day before. Because with the store being closed, usually you could post. They would post the schedule, but since the store is technically closed, you can't print out a schedule off the computer.
Right.
So, I mean, I know my hours. I didn't know her hours. I didn't know she didn't show up the night. And so I'm like, oh, so you knew somebody was supposed to be here, that they're not coming in and you've made no effort or at least a warning, oh, by the way, this person didn't show up. You know, give me a fucking heads up when you're going to fuck me. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
And so I'm like, there's just two of us in a store with lines down the fucking aisles. He goes, make it work. And he fucking hangs up on me. So that shows. And then that pisses me off and it gets me angry. Peace. Yeah. Goose fraba. But then my district manager comes into the store because everything's 75% off. And he's about to go on vacation, but he sees how crazy things are in the store. And I told, you see the condition I was left in, and the manager made no fucking attempts to fucking do any kind of, you know, that kind of attitude makes you a liability. You know, and I may get fired. I know for doing this video, I may get fired for talking the shit that I'm talking. Or even the manager, maybe he wants to fucking meet me in a parking lot to fight. But you know what I'm saying? I could fucking say that when I go to work to fucking work. I don't goof off. You know, I'm not fucking lazy. I'm sorry. I'm just venting. But you know, being put in charge doesn't make you a leader.
What did the district manager do about it?
Oh no, well he saw it and you know, and he, like by that time he said, look, you know, if you need to close early and this and this and that, you know, get the store organized because the store looked like hell. And I'm like, well, how can I get it organized? It's two of us on the registers ringing people out all day, you know, and I'm supposed to be a supervisor, you know, and then like we're scheduled to leave like a half an hour after we close. I can't leave. I got fucking paperwork to do. I got shit to count down. I got shit I got to get organized. You know, he's like, you know, do what you got to do. Whatever hours you need, just take them, whatever. But, you know, to be left high and dry without even a fucking heads up of, hey, by the way, maybe you should, you know.
Well, see, that's why it's a good thing you're transferring to a new store.
Yeah. So, and I'm transferring to the store that the district manager works out of. So at least now, you know, at least. Yeah, I'll be fired by the end of this week. Well, Mr. Cologne, we saw your video on Facebook. And
I don't think that's going to happen, but okay.
Fire me. You'll be doing me a favor. I'm sorry. I don't mean that. I'm taking medication right now. I'm loopy in the head. I'm not taking medication. Or am I? Is it a joke? Is it not a joke? We don't know. Okay.
So I'm just going to go upstairs.
Okay. Football season has started. And I could give a flying fuck.
I know, I saw that.
I don't care. Something, I don't care. Okay, the NFL. All right. I know we spoke about this last episode. I just want to say just a little bit more about this Kaepernick. Because here we are on 9/11.
People have joined him.
Other people have joined him. And they took a knee during... Their national anthem.
Well, okay, so there were some teams that just locked arms, mm-hmm. which I think was okay, because, you know, that's still showing respect for the flag and still, you know, not, like, dissing anybody. But then there were people that were taking a knee, and it's just like...
And okay, now here my argument, you know. This is the United States of America, where we have freedom of speech. Yes. You have freedom of speech. Meaning.
I feel like you're going to explode.
You can't get arrested for something you say. Other than, like, you know, being in a public place and screaming fire. Or, you know, saying, I'm going to do harm to our commander-in-chief. I don't even want to say the words, but you know what I mean? You know, other than
there's some idiots that are voting for Trump that are doing that.
Yeah, well, I'm just saying is, you know, if you're making a threat, okay, you can be arrested for making a threat. But for all intents and purposes, okay, it is your freedom of speech to sit down. That being said, right when he's sitting down during the national anthem, he's on the books. He's on the job. He's at that particular moment. He's working for the NFL, and the NFL has like policies. You can't go out and do drugs and still work for the NFL. You can't. You know. I mean, of course. You know that guy. I mean, it took a while. That guy knocked out his wife in the fucking elevator. And he lost his job. But, okay. Doing drugs, knocking out your girlfriend, those are serious crimes and should be handled. So, but let's use freedom of speech. Let's just say this Cal Kaepernick, before this controversy came out, was at a press conference and somebody was yelling at him. Or someone asked him a very rough question. And he said, man, fuck you. the NFL would fine him. Saying he'd be suspended for a couple of games, maybe a game, just to send a message where, no, you can't, you don't have freedom of speech. When you work for us and you're on the clock, you don't have freedom of speech. So him sitting down isn't freedom. I'm not saying throw him in jail. I'm saying the NFL should do something about it.
Well, it looks like
hit him in the pocket.
It looks like it could get to that point. My problem with Colin Kaepernick was the whole fact of here's this backup quarterback, which he's a backup quarterback. Mm-hmm. Again, that's an issue I have because I'm sitting here going, okay, you were a starting quarterback at one point. You did take this team to the playoffs and almost to the Super Bowl. Well, actually, no, he got him into the Super Bowl, didn't he?
I
don't remember. I don't remember. But
I don't watch.
Here's the thing.
The National Felon.
Here's the thing. Like, you had plenty of times where if you were this angry about this issue, you could have complained as a starting quarterback of a team. Mm-hmm. Now that you're the backup quarterback, you're doing this. Now you're doing this.
Yeah,
there's a lot of people
crying for attention.
There's a lot of people that are saying that. They're going, why? Why are you doing this now? Why haven't you done this before? Mm-hmm. And if he really did what he was saying he was going to do, I haven't confirmed it yet, but apparently he's going to be donating like $1 million to, you know, charities and said communities. You know, that's a good step in the right direction. Then I give you a little bit more credit. Okay, fine. So you're putting your money where your mouth is. Now we can have a conversation. Because here's the thing, like, it's one thing if you're just, okay, well, I'm doing this to get attention, because that's what it seemed like to a lot of people. But it's another thing if you went and said, look, I'm donating $1 million, I'm putting my money where my mouth is, you know, I'm actually trying to show you people that I'm not being, like, whatever. If that's what you're doing, then fine, great. I can't think of the guy's name, Trent... they were talking about this on ESPN, I believe it was. I actually watched this before we did the podcast. What's his name? God, who is it? It's one of the names trending on Facebook right now, where the one guy that's next to him is just has this face like, I'm going to fucking strangle you. you'll have to look at the Facebook trends.
Facebook trends, okay.
Yeah, Facebook trends. You'll have to look, open it up, and I can tell you where it is.
But then again,
it's not Barry Sanders. It starts with a B, though.
Well, I should update I should refresh the page because I've kept the same one up.
Well, it keeps going up and down. These trends go up and down. It's really weird. But
it's not Mad Max Fury Road.
No,
hit sports because I'm actually on. I keep mine on the entertainment tab because I use entertainment to distract me on how fucking horrible life is.
Hit sports.
Oh, I had it on sports. I thought I had it on sports.
Randy Moss. You click that, and then it tells you what the guy that he was. It looks like he's pissed, but you know, from the video, he's actually listening. Trent okay. Dilfer. So what he was saying was, you know, he respects the fact that.
Hey Mario.
He respects the fact that he's doing a protest and that there's a cause behind this, but. Here's the thing, and he literally says this. He's like, you're a backup QB. Why are you saying this now? And by the way, there are other people that are... He's like, and by the way, there's slavery going on in this country right now. There are kids every day right now that are under slavery here in this country. And people want to put up... people want to protest that, but they don't do it in this way. Mm-hmm. You know? So, and he brought up a good point. It's like, you know, I understand what he's trying to do, but it's just like... You know, again, you are a backup QB for an NFL team. Granted, you were one of the best QBs in the league at one point. Mm-hmm. And you know what? I really, if you had done this when you were the head QB of 49ers, the starting QB, I wouldn't have a problem. I'm with you 100%. Mm-hmm. But you're not. You were already sitting on the bench. So I think, Chris, this is what I think happened. Mm-hmm. He was pissed because he's still the backup QB. Mm-hmm. So instead of the media just taking it for it is, just him just pissed on the bench, sitting there, they took it as he was protesting. So he ran with it. Wow. And You know what I mean? Like,
he was pouting like a petulant child.
And then, you know, he decided to run with it and started talking intelligently about it. And then when he realized that this started blowing up and he's like, oh, fuck, I actually should, you know, show that I want, you know, I'm behind this. That's when he donated money. And that's what I'm saying. Like, it's just that was my problem with it. Now, you have my attention that if you did actually donate, you have my attention. I'm not going to hit on you. I'm not going to, you know, take it against you. But the one thing that pissed me off about this weekend on Sunday was all these players disrespecting 9/11. Any other day, you want to do this on any other Sunday, go right ahead. Mm-hmm. Go right ahead and do what you want. This is 9/11. These are first responders that went into a building and died trying to save people. Mm-hmm. Fuck you for protesting.
Yeah.
Fuck you for protesting. And that's it. And I'm done.
The NFL the NFL should do something. And like, you know, and then,
but see, here's the problem. You can't. I understand that you want the NFL to do something, but they can't. That's a freedom of speech. That's a God-given right that you get.
But
by
like
the
I said, if he was at a press conference and said "fuck you,"
now this is what should happen.
You don't have when you're on the clock. You don't have freedom of speech.
Here's what should happen. This is what I'm saying to you. This is what should happen. The coach and the owner of whatever team of these people that are protesting should come together and say, "Look, you've proven your point. You're not going to do this anymore. And for every time that you do this, you're going to be fined X amount of dollars. Okay? This is the United States of America. You guys are an example for our team. You need to stand up and, you know, respect the flag. If you don't want to respect the flag, you can sit on that bench or you can go in the locker room and sit in the locker room."
Yeah.
That's what I'm saying.
Because like, we got thousands of people lined up for your fucking job. You know what I'm saying?
Like, well, it's not even that.
It's more or less
the fact that there's people. It's not that there's people lined up. I don't think that somebody can replace, like, we'll use Thurman Thomas, for example. There was nobody that really could replace Thurman Thomas. In my opinion, there's nobody that could replace Fred Jackson. You know, and I still don't understand why the Bills traded him off. He's still a better running back than what they have, besides LeSean.
You're speaking Greek to me.
Yes, right? I know, but here's the point I'm trying to make. Like, I understand that, you know, there are problems in this country and we protest, but it's how you protest and the appropriate way to go about it. Mm-hmm. I mean, I think that he's doing some stuff, but I think that other people trying to follow his course, so to speak, maybe shouldn't do that.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? But we should move on from that.
We should move, yeah. I don't know if that's going to... Okay, if you hear that noise in the background, that is the...
Water heater
turning on. Danny says, "Paul, you were right." And Danny, I didn't... you know, once again, and thank you, Danny, for... Danny had sent me this... I don't know if it's a tea or a pop iron brew from Scotland. He had sent it to me. Well, he came to Florida. And he mailed it from Florida. Heck of a lot cheaper than mailing it.
Yeah, that is. Good job there.
But he watches America. I have to say American football because he's from the UK.
Well, yeah, soccer. Football, soccer.
But he watches American football, which I'm surprised that.
I mean, I think they call football over there American football or Americano. It's football Americano.
But I'm just saying is that, like, I didn't realize. One, that they had the coverage in Scotland, you know, saying like...
Well, they do.
Know.
That's why they have like one or two games a year overseas.
Oh, okay.
And that's the thing. Like, a lot of people go to those. Like, it's they're sitting there going, yeah, I'm going to watch this stuff.
But Danny, answer this question. Is it, if you watch American football, are your parents or are older people sort of like disappointed in you? Like are you like the disgrace? I tease... Like, Paul's other podcast, the Tsunami Faithful, you know, all those guys watch anime. And when we had the roast, when we had Paul's birthday roast last year, I was like, none of you guys remember Pearl Harbor? You don't remember the Japanese bombing the United States? You know, how dare you watch anime? You know, and I said it as a joke, but I wonder if people overseas watch American football, do they look at the people watching American football like, that's bullshit. That's, you know, you know, that, you know, there's only one football, and it's the one that's, you know, I'm sure there were nobody touched the ball with their hands. And
one other thing I do want to stress too is, you know, as far as this whole protest thing goes, there's no merit behind it unless those people that are protesting are actually donating as well. The one thing that I always say is put your money where your mouth is. Mm-hmm. These people clearly have money. If they want to protest, put your money where your mouth is and donate.
And it's documented the size of Cal Kaepernick's sneaker collection.
Oh yeah, you know, they showed that.
Google Kaepernick sneaker collection. He said, and you see the pictures. He can't park his car in his own garage because he turned his garage into a sneaker museum. So
stupid. What'd he say?
Okay. Danny says he has relatives from Colorado, so he likes Denver. He goes, no, my gran and granddad took me to Scottish Claymores. Rugby fans diss you and say pads are for pussies. And they don't get the concept. Why, that's true. I didn't even think about rugby. I didn't even think about that. Yeah, we're pussies. Yeah, you know. I don't know. I don't watch the National Fellow.
Well, they don't wear any equipment, too, when they play that shit, so.
Yeah.
Some Europeans are fucking crazy. Let's just put it that way. Moving on.
Okay, so.
Fuck RockCon.
Okay, so we. As Paul and I, Paul and mine, our history, we met at RockCon. That's how we, you know, that's how we came together as co-hosts. But I totally forgot RockCon was in Rochester this week. And well, I say it's in like it came from somewhere else. It's from Rochester. People from here organize it. But it is sad when your biggest draw, their biggest RockCon, Rochester's anime and science fiction and fantasy.
Lou Ferrigno.
Kenan from Kenan and Kel.
Yeah.
And Lou Ferrigno were the big draws this week. So, now what happened was I missed it on Friday. I got out of work early, but I was uploading episodes of the podcast, and I was like, let me just go and take care of this. And then Saturday came along, and I'm like, oh, I'll go Saturday after work. So I got out of work around 6, and I'm like, okay, it'll be open till 10. And, you know, I'll pay the full price and only just spend 4 hours in there. Just to distract myself, forget how horrible life is. And I go, and I didn't realize the fucking place closes at 6. Who the fuck closes at 6 on a Saturday?
And here's the thing, convention? Any convention that is good will not close before 10.
Yeah. Well, when they were in the other building here in Rochester, the other building was...
they were open until 9 in the other building.
The other building was, they had it in the Main Street Armory. And in all fairness, the Main Street Armory hosts shows that go to like 11, like music shows. So, you know, them staying open till 9 or 10. But, I mean, to close at 6 on a Saturday, are you shooting yourself in the foot? I wonder if it's a venue thing because they actually...
It might have been.
It's funny because it's given in the Kodak building. And in case you haven't been watching Kodak the news, the Kodak Theater... Kodak ain't doing so well. Everything's digital now. I'm just saying is that they like when I applied for the job working for the fucking the medical marijuana.
Yeah.
They use that building. They use that.
Yeah,
hall.
They do. No. They use it. They do that
to interview people. So I've been inside the building. They rent out the space. But I mean, like, is there really an issue with people leaving that building at 9 o'clock at night? There shouldn't be. It's a main thoroughfare. It's a main street. It's off of two main streets, as a matter of fact.
I honestly think that's. I don't know if they did that last year, but I will say that I think that that's part of the reason why nobody really likes this con anymore. Mm-hmm. There are some people that are kind of naive to this, but RockCon is very badly run. There's a reason. Let me put it to you this way. I talked to, and I'm not going to say his name, I'm not going to say who I was talking to. Mm-hmm. I talked to somebody that was at Flower City Comic Con. It's a new con.
The new one that just started.
And, you know, which I have to email him again and be like, hey, are we going to meet up so I can talk about who I want there? You know, oh, it looks like we got some more stuff, but hold on a minute.
Uh-huh.
So let me finish this really quick. But, you know, one of the things, the reasons why they broke off from them is because they didn't like how she ran it. She ran it terribly. Hmm. And she does still run it terribly. The year before, they tried to crowdfund money so that way they could get more guests. Who the fuck? No con crowdfunds. I understand. Look, I understand there's a competition now to get people. But if you have to crowdfund to get people, then you're not doing your job.
Yeah, you're not. Yeah, people should be coming to you,
right,
saying, "I want to be at your con." You know, can I please? How much is a booth? People should be paying you to be at your
con. And by the way, like when I was doing it, I was trying to get like a panel, so that way I could do a panel and whatnot. And they never gave me a panel. Like it was like, it was so poorly run that it was, it just boggled my mind that this place was actually, you know, even doing a con, because these people did not know what they were doing. It was the head lady. It wasn't anybody else. It was the head lady. Mm-hmm. So.
And yeah. And Jen says they have later shows at that theater. Now, where was Flower City?
Flower City was in the convention, in the Rochester Convention Center. So.
And yeah, where's that? I don't even know where that lives, and I live here. I don't even know where that is, and I live here.
It's so St. Paul. It's in between St. Paul and. Not Culver, Clinton, in the middle of the city. So.
That's a scary area.
No, it's not. It's actually not scary anymore because they because of what. So when they moved the terminal, It took a lot of people. So like it's a ghost town down there now.
Oh, okay. I'm just saying. Look, it's like Clinton. I think people. Once again, for local news, for the wonderful local news for all the people out around the world listening to this podcast, you know, two people got shot on like Clinton today. Where one guy got shot and got killed, the other guy who got shot ran away. The cops can't even find the guy. This is the person who got shot and ran away. So, you know, and on Clinton, which is, if I'm not
mistaken, sure they'll find him. I'm sure he'll go to the hospital or whatnot. But
a guy with a hole in him ran. You know things are bad when you got to run before the cops show up.
So
when you got shot. So we're talking to, okay, go on, I'm sorry.
So Buffalo.
Buffalo. Okay, so, okay, now I could kind of talk about...
Why the hell did you go all the way to Buffalo?
Okay, so the last time we recorded the episode, the last episode we did, we were recording on August 30th. We were recording the night of the Fathom events where, you know, Kevin Smith, he was given yoga hosers, and it was a deal where you see the movie, but there's also like a half an hour of Kevin Smith talking before the movie, which I guess it was at, I think they were showing it down in his, you know, but down by his neck of the woods in South Jersey. So we did a half an hour intro. It was filmed, and they gave it before the movie, in the theaters. Now, had a certain co-host answered my fucking texts, and we had recorded a couple days earlier like we were planning to, I would have went to the Fathom events on that Tuesday because, you know, we would have already had a show recorded, and... And now, okay, here's
blaming
the funny,
me.
And here's the funny thing is that we were the Fathom event thing happened in Webster, and that was August 30th, the Tuesday. So then the movie hits theaters September 2nd, the Friday. So I'm like, okay, I'll go to the theater that has the Fathom events, the theater in Webster. And for people outside of Rochester, people don't know, or to make you sort of kind of care. I mean, it's a suburb of Rochester. It's, you know, a nicer, whiter area. And not that nice equals white, but that's just truth. It's a nicer, whiter area. So I'm like, all right, I'll go to the Webster Theater. Well, what happens? The Webster Theater isn't giving yoga hosers. That's in the Kevin Smith movie, yoga hosers. And I'm like, so you're hosting the fucking Fathom event, but you won't host the movie that you just showed. I'm going to send, you know, the Fathom event because it's a little extra content. You're going to have super fans going to come out. But, oh, but you're still giving fucking Ghostbusters? You're still giving fucking Independence Day 2, but you're not going to fucking give them a brand new movie yoga hoses? I'm pretty sure had they had fucking yoga hosers, they probably would have had at least, it could definitely be more than whoever the fuck showed up on September 2nd to see fucking Ghostbusters and Independence Day 2, you know?
Right.
So what happened was, since Labor Day was earlier in the week, that counts as a holiday, it's hours on my paycheck, so heavens forbid they give me overtime. So I had Thursday off. So I said, you know what? Fuck it. They're giving it out in Buffalo. And now, mind you, I go to Fandango, and it's like, you know, put in your zip codes. I put in a zip code. It doesn't let you. There are no showings in your area. Okay. Well, then just give me an idea where the closest show is. You know what I'm saying? So I'm like, okay. I look up zip codes for Syracuse. You know, nothing. They weren't giving a Syracuse. And I said, all right, let me go 60 miles in the other direction. And I look, and it's, and so, putting zip codes for Buffalo, oh, it's playing at this theater called the Screening Room. Okay? So, 80 miles one way, 80 miles back. I put 160 miles on my car that day to go see a fucking movie. But you know what? I'm a Kevin Smith supporter. I don't do, you know, I don't do shit like this. I don't fuck, you know what I'm saying? Like, I mean, on the occasion, you know, I mean, I like to go to the theater.
So what is this theater looks like now?
Okay, so here's the funny thing. This Screening Room theater, you know, quaint is probably the best way to describe it. It's like a VFW hall, like a Veterans of Foreign War hall. Now, I mean, it's supposed to be a theater. And, you know, so you walk in, it almost looks like you're walking into... A warehouse is not the right word, because the warehouse makes me think it's big. It's big enough for an average-sized screen, but it's not on a curtain. It's almost like on a stage. Right. And actually, according to the signs that I saw, I guess it can be turned into a stage because they have, like, a comedian coming, like, later on in the week. So, I don't know if, like, maybe a thing comes down or whatever and goes in front of the stage, but they have the screen, and they have, like, movie memorabilia on the wall, but it's like Dick Tracy posting from fucking the early 90s, you know, fucking Free Jack. You remember that movie Free Jack with, like, Emilio Estevez and like, the lead and the singer from Rolling Stones, you know, you know, I mean, they have Hollywood, quote-unquote Hollywood stuff, but it's just, it's probably shit that they got from, like, a video store that, like, you know, we're going to throw this out. Do you want it?
Yeah.
It was a nice place. The people were friendly. When you sat in a room, like I said, the closest thing I think was, like, a VFW hall, like a place where they had tables. They even had fucking couches. Like, I was sitting at a table with, like, four chairs, a nice comfortable chair. But, like, the guys sitting next to me were, like, literally sitting in recliners. And then in the back, there was, like, a couch. And you can order beer. Not that that fucking helps me. You can order popcorn and soda, but no food. Like, popcorn was the only food. I mean, I think they offer things, but, like, the only thing that even, like, was appealing. But, I mean, you would think, like, chicken wings or
I mean, other finger like, the foods stuff, the stuff, like, yeah, the stuff you can just throw in the oven for, like...
Yeah, you throw in the microwave or whatever.
Yeah.
But, so, I mean... I don't want to disparage the place. I mean, was it quaint? Yes, it was quaint. Was it a little rundown, shitty place? Yeah, I guess.
I'm gonna look this place up.
Yeah, I mean, but they, you know, they meant well. You know what I'm saying? Like, I don't think it's a. And then when you get there, it's like on. It's in a strip mall where like everything around it's like shut down. So, you know, was it a nice place? Yeah, it was a nice place. But, you know, if it was in Rochester, I would go there to see more movies, just because it's quaint. But, like, you know, it's definitely not, it's not corporate in any way, shape, or form. But I guess somehow they got the okay to play the movie, you know. It's like going to a fucking friend's house.
How much did it cost?
It was average price. I think I paid like $9-$10 or something like that. Because then I got soda and I got popcorn and all that shit. I think altogether I paid like maybe like $16 or something like that. You know, they jacked up the price of the popcorn and the fucking soda. So I saw Yoga Hosers. Just, it's a weird fucking movie, you know. It's part two of his True North trilogy. The first movie, one guy captures another guy and turns him into a walrus called Tusk. And so in that first movie, there's a scene with two convenience store workers, Kevin Smith's daughter and Johnny Depp's daughter. And so then the whole second movie is about them. And I won't spoil it, so to anyone listening and watching, I'm not spoiling it. But, it turns out that under the convenience store, there was a guy who was trying to be the Adolf Hitler of Canada, and he had started these crazy...
I'm still listening to you. I'm just trying to look this up.
He started this... It's the most fucking whacked out fucking marijuana fucking idea. He started these mad experiments with making these little men out of bratwurst that were little Nazis. So they're called Bratsies. And then the Bratsies come up and the girls fight the Bratsies, and then there's a little more to it. But, I mean, it was funny at times. I felt like a dirty old man looking at Kevin Smith's daughter, because it's called...
You are a dirty old man.
I guess I am a perverted or evil old man. But, you know, it's called Yoga Hosers. She's in the movie doing yoga. And Johnny Depp's daughter's in the movie doing yoga. And they're like 17. But the camera's like right up her ass. I mean, how could you not... You know, and she's at that age where, like, she's not, I mean, she's awkward, but, you know, She's shaped like a woman, you know what I'm saying?
I see what you're doing. I see, like, this is just... It's like an independent theater, basically.
It's an independent theater, but it's like going to someone... It's like the closest thing... The best thing I say is like a VFW hall. It's like, you know... Because there is... Then when you have to go to the bathroom, you walk to this other room, which is set up straight up like a bar. Right. Not like a bar, but, you know, a place where people can sit down and drinks can be served at a counter. And then you go through there to get to the bathroom.
In a counter.
Yeah, it's not, like I said, it's not a bad place. I'm not shitting on it. I'm just saying it's like mom and, it's like super duper mom and pop movie theater. Okay. I got a chance to watch Sausage Party.
Yeah.
That movie is fucked up, man. That's, talk about another movie that involves sausages, like the Bratzies, and involves a stoner writing it. Seth Rogen and his buddies wrote it. Sausage Party, when you watch the movie in the beginning, it's like they're trying really hard to curse every second. Even a person like me who curses all the time, I don't curse that fucking much. Holy fuck, holy shitballs, holy asshole, you're a scumbag.
So you do, never mind.
Every 2 seconds, they're cursing. And I think they kind of did it more in the beginning, just so if you're a parent and you're like, oh, this is VeggieTales. No, you ain't fucking to go see no VeggieTales. When you go into see, you know, when you see curses in the beginning of the movie, I think it gives the parents enough fucking heads up to like, okay, get the fuck out of the theater. But the ending of the movie, towards the end, it gets really fucked up. Like, you know, like, I mean, and don't get me wrong, I'm not saying it's a bad movie. It's in no way is it a bad movie, because it's a well-structured movie, and had they took the adult jokes out of it, I think you could have made this a kid's movie. Okay, maybe the... All right, maybe not the idea of them getting, you know, the fucking violent scenes where they're eaten by people and, like, they're dying and shit like that. But you could have done that enough where food, like, gets scared that they don't want to get eaten or whatever. But, you know, once it gets towards the end, it gets really, really, really fucked up. Like, I'm still haunted by that fucking movie. And, like, you know, like I said, it's not a bad movie. It is a well-structured movie. It's just... You know, I think they said, oh, we could do anything. So they did anything. And it's really weird. And I guess mostly because, I guess, you know, I mean, of course you watch Adult Swim and you watch shows, you know, we're used to cartoons cursing. That's nothing new. But, like, they turned it up to 11. It's a really fucked up movie. I kind of teased this before the episode. I kind of teased this on Facebook. And yeah, no. What's in the box? What's in the box?
In this sense, what's in the...
What's in the envelope? What's in the envelope? Where's the trigger? Make sure I have them holding the right side so it's not seen on the screen. Press pass. I feel bad because I know people who were denied the press pass this year. And,
So do I. He's probably going to kill you right now.
Yeah, I mean, so... I hate to say it, but nana boo boo. No, I mean, I'm so fucking happy I got it. Oh, let me, the light's in the way. That's the press pass. And then, I don't know, Walking Dead must be spending a lot of fucking money on, because this is my third year at New York Comic Con, and it's
sponsored it.
It's the third year that it's been Walking Dead themed. Because on the back, it's sort of, not personal information, but there's sort of like a serial number, so I'm not going to show you the back. But... The front, but and there's an RFID chip. When you show up to Comic Con, you go. You actually have to register and show your ID. They zap you on this little machine, and then every time you come in and out of the building, they got these people with like iPads or something, and you press it up against the iPad, and it beeps. And so they keep track of when you're in and out. They make sure you're not like you show it to get in, and you give it to your friend behind you or something like that. I'm super excited. We're gearing up for New York Comic Con, so
Matt's got his badge too.
And Matt, the cameraman who's been with us for the past 2 years.
Don't worry, Chris will be my bitch again this year.
I'll be more than happy to be your bitch if I had half as much fun as I did last year and the year before that. I'll be more than happy to go to Comic Con and be a bitch. Call me a bitch, I'll bend over. Little things. Today is National Video Games Day. And it's so sad because, like, ever since I moved, I packed up games that, like, I haven't had in a while. Oh, Danny says, jammin'! Enjoy NYCC. And, yeah, thank you. I packed up a lot of stuff, and so I'm still, you know, every now and then you look for something, you see you're starting packing. I have so many, I bought games used, you know, GameStop, you know, $10, $15, $20. I have so many games that I haven't gotten around to playing, because I'm still, like, right now I'm playing Fallout 4. I think I beat Fallout 4 to the point where there are no missions. Now, I haven't done any of the new DLC, and there's like 4 or 5 DLCs, so like once I go and I start, once I get Wi-Fi back, I can download it to my PlayStation 4. There's one called Far Harbor. There's one called Robotronics or some shit like that. You know, Nuka City or some shit like that. There's 3 or 4 like DLCs which are going to add to the game. But I still haven't played Fallout New Vegas for the PlayStation 3. And I've listed the games that I have that I haven't even touched yet. Fallout New Vegas, Borderlands 2, Bioshock Infinite, which is, and then I actually bought like the special edition Bioshock. And once again, it's used, but it's a special edition Bioshock Infinite, which comes with the first Bioshock in the package. And this is gonna, Transformers Devastation, and this is for PlayStation 4. Transformers Devastation, and then a gift for my dad, the Lego game, the Lego movie game that it's like a fucking $100, like comes with the whole thing. I haven't had a chance to play it, because I'm like, well, one, you need to be online to play it. And I'm like, I'm going to dedicate some time to this, and I just haven't had a chance to. You know, I guess it's good that I'm busy, but I got all these games. If I ever break my leg or something and I'm stuck at work or stuck at home, I guess I'll have plenty of entertainment. Star Trek at 50, I really don't have anything to say about that.
What's
up? Well, I'm saying, it's Star Trek. It's Star Trek. And you can't, what else can we say that it's a fucking awesome show?
By the way,
show?
I actually saw it the other day. I actually watched, I finally got to see Star Trek. What the hell was the name of it?
Oh,
can't even think of it right now. I'm so tired.
Not Into Darkness. No.
Not Into Darkness. It's the one that just came out. Oh, Star Trek Beyond.
Star Trek Beyond.
Yeah. It was
fucking
really
movie,
good.
Right? Yeah.
Really good. Like, I was... It's really refreshing because, see, the last two kind of just jumped off the original trilogy. Mm-hmm. And then this one was kind of its own, like, own story.
Yeah.
And what I liked about it the most was... It did kind of take from, I guess, the whole Khan storyline where, like, at the end... No, well, actually, that's right, because there was something in the middle there.
Spoilers.
Right. No, I mean, if you haven't seen the original, but, like, you know, having the Enterprise 1701A.
Mm-hmm.
So, and it looks more like the ship than what it did. But you know what I'm really looking forward to is seeing how they, because I know they're coming, they're going to start to get closer to this, is what are they going to do now, because this is an alternate universe, what are they going to do with, you know, when they get to Captain Picard and all that shit.
Oh, next generation?
Wait.
Oh,
I can't wait. Oh, my God. Like, nerdgasm all over this desk.
Regeneration. Star Trek.
And then have Patrick Stewart come back for a little bit.
Star Trek Regeneration. Regeneration.
Well, and see, that's the other thing, too, is they've been trying to... They want to bring William Shatner into the fold a little bit, too. So it would be very interesting to see if somehow he's...
Well, the guy's in his fucking 80s. Hurry up, man.
Well, if you remember that one part at the end there where he opens up Spock's stuff, and then there's a picture from the original crew, and it's just like, this is just so interesting to see this. You know what I mean? Like,
yeah, and you could explain it anyway. Transporter malfunction from another dimension, hologram. You know, maybe an alien pretending to be Kirk, but I mean, it being William Shatner, but you know, it's an alien pretending to be Kirk from another dimension,
right?
You know, before he dies or whatever. Spoiler, but then again, he is dead. It's just someone pretending to be him. Khan. Oh, Danny. Okay, Danny says. Oh, when we were talking about video games, I played the same game for years, Battlefield, upgraded the console, and got the same game. Well, if a game's fun, it's fun. I mean, don't get me wrong. It's, you know, I got sucked up in Fallout. I really loved it. It's a really deep game. And like I said, since I can't get any of the DLC, I'm looking for stuff to do in the game. Because there's a lot of hidden stuff. And I still haven't, I don't think I've found everything that I can find. But and then he goes, "Khan!" No spoilers. Okay. Well, actually, what I liked about Star Trek Beyond, and I don't know if I said this when we were talking about it a couple episodes back, is that it felt like an episode of Star Trek.
That movie?
Yeah. It felt like they said, "Okay, let's make an episode, as if this is one part of a larger machine, but give it a fucking gigantic budget."
You know what the one thing I found really interesting about.
And I mean that in the best possible way.
Right. No, what I found really interesting, though, about this movie was the fact that... Because, see, this is something that we never got to see in the original series or even in the movies with the original cast was... because you've seen it, right? And I mean, if you haven't seen it, too fucking bad. I'm going to spoil something.
Danny's saying no spoilers.
I'm kind of going to spoil something. It's not like anything major, but... they actually, like, they separated the saucer section from the ship.
They do that in every fucking movie.
That's the thing. Like, you're sitting there going, wait a minute. This never happened in the original series. By the way, they never said that the Constitution-class ships could do this. And it's just like, what? Like, are you serious? Like, that, I'm like... I mean, again, nerdgasm. I'm like, oh.
It's a new universe.
But you know, like, because you saw
J.J.
that.
J.J. Abrams.
sorry to geek out a little bit here, but, you know, you saw that with Next Generation where, like, you know, the Galaxy-class starships. Yes, shut up. I'm a geek. Fuck all of you. I love Star Trek. the Galaxy-class starships can separate. There's a saucer section and then the other section. Mm-hmm. The other section is actually called the battle section. So, it's just so interesting to see that, wait a minute, so back then, before any of that happened, they were already doing this, and they had already thought about doing this. It's like, wow, okay. And maybe that was something that they just added.
Well, I mean, you could always just say it was something they could have done, they just didn't ever do it.
True. You know,
it was always an option, they just never had it. They always had the ace up their sleeve, they just never
could
used
be.
It. You know, I my favorite part of the movie was when they get to the...
What was said?
Geek out. Yeah. when they get to the planet and it looks like... Okay, when you watch Star Trek, the original series, you go to a planet and they look cheesy. You know what I'm saying? It was obviously made with fucking, you know, wire hangers and paper mache and all this stuff. So they took... what would the paper mache and the wire hangers were trying to represent and made it real. Like, they made it like, you know, here's a crooked tree and here's an orange fucking sky, you know. And what looked shitty, they made look legit based on shitty pictures, you know what I'm saying?
But you kind of have to respect.
It's like when you're a kid and you put a fucking bucket on your head and you're like, I'm Darth Vader. You know, the 60s version is the person standing there with a fucking towel around their neck, with a black towel and a fucking bucket on it saying, I'm Darth Vader, with a flashlight.
Yeah.
And then the movie version is Darth Vader. You know, I like that, you know, they took what could have been a cheesy concept or what was probably originally a cheesy concept and made it look big fucking budget, you know, and I don't know. There was a sort of a retro feel to it that I fucking loved. And that's like my favorite. And like I said, in the beginning of the part of the movie, and I know I said this in the other podcast, what I liked about the movie is that, like, James T. Kirk, he's kind of giving a speech, and it's true. He's like, we're all we got out here. We're a ship. We're exploring the fucking edges of the fucking galaxy. We're here to boldly go where no one has gone before. If shit fucks up, we're all we got. You know, and you know, it definitely had a feeling to that. And I, you know, you never really thought about that before. Like, we really are out in the middle of nowhere. And, you know, what could possibly be hostile, you know, you don't know. And if shit happens, all we can do is rely on the guy standing next to you, which I thought was pretty fucking cool. Let me see. As for, all right, that's pretty much it.
Yeah.
I went shopping. Okay, so when I realized RockCon was fucking not, I said, let me do a little clothes shopping. I'm a fat fuck. Let me go get some clothes. Not wearing nice stuff like I'm wearing now. So I went to the store, and I'm a little frustrated that, like, when you're a fat guy and you're trying to buy a 4X or a 5X shirt, that
I don't want to know where this is going.
No. I'm saying is there's plenty of, like, why is it everything that's large is sort of like hip-hop stuff? Like, you know, like South Pole and Sean John. And don't get me wrong, you know, I appreciate that those companies make clothes for larger guys. But I don't really, hip-hop's not my style. You know, I'm more of a, you know, rock and roll, right, heavy metal kind of guy. And I'm not expecting shirts that say fucking Metallica or whatever. You know, and oddly enough, I got a Guns N' Roses shirt. I'm not even a Guns N' Roses fan, but that's like the closest thing I could fucking get, you know, to, you know, that would fit me without looking ridiculous. You know, it's just, but I mean, you know, but also like if you, even like button down shirts and stuff like that, it looks like stuff that, you know, and I don't want to get negative. It looks like something, a shirt someone would wear if that's the same kind of person that stands outside of a corner store all day. You know, and it's like, you know, can't you just make halfway decent plain stuff? And not so plain that you look like fucking, like, you know, you're working in construction. So flashy that it looks like, you know, you're, you know, trying to be an extra in a fucking hip-hop video. You know what I'm saying? Can we meet a happy fucking medium, especially when it comes to large sizes? And why can't you take the stuff that's, you know, the halfway decent designs that are regular size and just make it bigger? What's so fun? Use a little more cloth. Keep the same fucking, you know, keep the same proportions, just make it bigger. So it sucks, right, you know. Oh, so Danny asks, have you seen the new Tick pilot? Just watched. Wow.
It looks like shit.
No, well, the suit looks like shit, and confirming, like, what Danny's, I haven't watched it yet, but I heard it's good. It's on Amazon, so I believe the idea is, if it gets a good enough response, Amazon will put more money into making a series of it, but I heard it's good. You know, the suit kind of really messed me up. I haven't had a chance to. The only thing, the only other new show, I mean, I've been seeing movies. The only for a guy that doesn't have Wi-Fi, I started watching The Get Down on Netflix. It's about, like, the South Bronx in the late 70s, early 80s.
You were watching this shit at the library, weren't you?
I was watching in the library.
You're fucking asshole.
Because there are sites out there where you can watch Netflix shows. Okay, so Danny says, LOL, it's good. And that's what I heard. I heard it's good. I'm just saying it's the suit looks shitty, or at least from what I've seen on the, you know. And I like the actor, you know. I liked him in all the Shaun of the Dead movies, and I liked him in his few minutes in Guardians of the Galaxy. I know, I can't believe Peter Serafinowicz or some shit like that. So, I'm all for it. I'm pretty sure I'll enjoy it when I watch it. But like I said, I've been watching The Get Down, and I've only watched like the first episode. But the first episode, like two episodes in a row, it's an hour and a half or whatever. It's, I mean, maybe because it's the pilot also. I'm really fucking digging it. For someone who grew up in New York City in the early 80s, I mean, you know, not, I wasn't, and of course, this show's, it's a stylized show. It's no way supposed to be realistic at all. It's very, right. But it takes the aesthetic of early 80s New York City, burnt out fucking buildings and fucking the projects and shit like that. And it, like, I watched that movie and I felt fucking homesick. Like, I missed my dirty apple. I missed my dirty, disgusting New York City with graffiti on the trains and stuff like that.
Of course you did.
Like I said, it's stylized. It's not in no way, shape, or form trying to be realistic. But for what I saw, I enjoyed it. So I think
that's going to be it, yes.
I think we should wrap it up.
That's what she said.
I'm sorry. I was reading Danny's comment and I kind of got messed up. Danny says, the show's good fun. Nonsense. Yeah, well, what the Tick always was, you know. And, like, every, like, free comic book day, I always pick up, they always have, like, a Tick comic. That's one of the few comics I got to say that every year on free comic book day, they put one out, you know. And, of course, obviously, we're fans of the 90s cartoon show. I wasn't aware the comic book even existed before the cartoon. But I do always pick up the free comic book day ones, and they're always pretty fucking funny. And, you know, someone should go back and revisit that world and give us some more up-to-date satire. As, you know, and if we got a world where we're fucking, you know, we got big budget, you know, Batman v Superman, I'm pretty sure someone could throw a couple of bucks and give us a halfway decent Tick show. You know, we got Flash and Supergirl and Spoon! All right, so let's wrap this up. That's what she said.
No.
No. Okay.
I need $5 if I'm going to say that.
please visit twostrangersonepodcast.net where you can find all things show-related. First and foremost, you can find links to our iTunes page. And luckily, I had to go back and look at our iTunes page because I had misnumbered some of the episodes back around episode like 133, 134. Well, I think I accidentally numbered episode 132, 133. So I was like, where the hell? Why can't I find 132? But it's or something to that effect. So one of the episodes are misnumbered. And I think that episode's not even available anymore. Or I'll be uploading it to YouTube soon, so it won't be available on iTunes anymore. But are the links still work on iTunes? Which, once again, this all may change soon when I switch over to SoundCloud. But the links will still be there, because iTunes, I just have to let them know the new feed through SoundCloud. And the same thing with Stitcher. If you don't have an iPhone, an iPad, or an iPod, and don't even get me started on a new fucking iPhone, because I was going to talk about that in the show, but how they took off the...
we'll leave it for the next show.
But I just want to talk real quick. They took off the headphone jack. And they're like, okay, that's really stupid. But then someone put a post, and it's like, yeah, you know how they have those card readers, like Square and PayPal? They had those things where you could use your phone as a, like, to swipe a credit card? Well, people were using that instead of Apple Pay. So the whole reason they got rid of the headphone jack was so people don't have those little dongles, dongle, and so people, you know, they don't have these dongles to dongles. So you're forced to use Apple Pay, and you know what's gonna happen? Someone's gonna make those dongles, but they're gonna make it Bluetooth powered. So Apple, stop trying to fucking, you know, be more proprietary with your shit. All that someone has to do is make the same. Now, of course, is it sketchy to fucking swipe some of your card in some fucking Bluetooth dongle? Yes, but as long as it pops up on the screen to sign and everything like that, it's sketchy to fucking give anyone with a phone your fucking credit card. But, you know, I'm pretty sure there'll be some sort of verification. As soon as you're done with the transaction, it could send you an email, it could send you a text. So, you know, fuck you, Apple, for taking away the fucking headphone jack. And then they want to charge you $160 for earbuds that fucking small that are Bluetooth that you know you're going to lose in 5 fucking minutes. Or you're going to lose one or some, you know, you're going to lose one with the controls on it or something. So, I'm sorry. I just had a rant there for a second. Okay. As I was saying, if you don't have an iPhone, iPad, iPod, if you've been so disgusted by the iProducts like I have, which is why I've never had an iPhone, you can find us on the Stitcher app. That's STITCHER, the Stitcher app for Android devices. It's what I use when I listen to podcasts. Mark Maron, Adam Carolla, Kevin Smith's Modcast, Chris Hardwick's Nerdist, and of course, Paul's other baby, the Toonami Faithful Podcast.
That's right, motherfucker.
Is available on Stitcher.
Damn straight.
And, you know, I haven't had a problem. I really haven't had a problem. You know, I always like to hit the listen later option and the available offline option. So we're in a Wi-Fi spot like I am right now. Download the episodes to my phone. So when I'm out and about, I can listen to them later without killing my data plan, without killing my battery. So Stitcher, and it's what I use. And, you know, it's always keeping me up to date. You know, I just have to make sure that I update it when I'm in a Wi-Fi spot. I always forget, and I'm like halfway, and I'm driving away, and I'm like, oh, I forgot to update my Stitcher. Which it does automatically update, but sometimes not all the time. If you're doing 50 other things on your phone, it won't automatically update.
Well, the podcast app on iPhone will certainly do that, that's for sure.
Yeah, if you want to write us, the first half of the show, we spent the first half an hour just reading a fan email. You can reach us at twostrangersonepodcast@gmail.com. That's all spelled out. twostrangersonepodcast@gmail.com. You can write to us the way Oscar does. We have been getting a lot of new downloads, a lot of new places from all over the world. So please check us out. Write to us. You can follow us on Facebook. Facebook.com/twostrangersonepodcast. It just takes 2 seconds to like our page. It takes 2 seconds to share this episode on your page. Once again, we want your money. We need your money. But if you can't give us any money, take 2 seconds and share us on Facebook. Because the more exposure we get, the better. And we've been getting a lot of new likes on Facebook, which is pretty fucking cool. And once again, we want your money. We need your money. But if you can't give us money, you can watch our videos on YouTube. Look, you want to do me a favor? I can't. I'm not telling you to click on the advertisements. Like, they say you can't tell people to click on advertisements. You can't tell people to, you know, open up a tab. If you want to help the show, find us. Go on YouTube, search for Two Strangers One Podcast, and just let the episode play in the background. If you're new to the podcast, you want to listen to old episodes, because that's where I'm putting all the old episodes. And if my calculations are correct, and if I'm not way too busy this week, we'll be up to date where every single episode of Two Strangers One Podcast will be up on YouTube. And you can also follow my Stranger blogs. You can watch me drink Iron Brew, which is a soda / tea soft drink all the way from Scotland. And let me see. You can follow us on Twitter at Stranger Podcast. Little at symbol, little twirly twirly at symbol, Stranger Podcast. And like our YouTube page, please. Even if you don't go on YouTube, just find Two Strangers One Podcast and subscribe. We need more subscribers so I can make a genuine page. You need 100 subscribers before you can start doing things to the page. And you know, right now, I mean, we have subscribers, and thank you very much for the people who have subscribed. But if you want to help the show, go on YouTube. Just let it play in the background. Turn off the volume. I don't care. Just let it play in the background. Let those minutes adds up, because you get more. Your stuff gets shared on other people's pages the more minutes that are used. So just play the fucking videos in the background. That'd be awesome. Once I get my Wi-Fi, I'm just going to start just playing episodes in the background. I acquiesce the floor to you, sir.
You can find me on Twitter at Paul Pasquillo. You can go to Instagram. It's Instagram.com/Paul Pasquillo. And, of course, you can ask me questions. It's ask.fm/Paul Pasquillo. So, yeah. I'll look at that picture.
Aww. It's me with hair. See, this is what happens. I got a dent right there.
That's what happens when I burn off your hair.
That happens when you get kicked in the head by your baby mama.
All right, here we go, man. Go ahead. You want
Double there? Jackpot.
What is it?
It is a self-published book by Christopher Colon.
Chris Colon? Smells good to me. Look at her. That broke that fucking cold little exterior. He's like, hee.
But it is spelled C-O-L-O-N.
Him punny.
But Double Jackpot is a book about a comic book artist, Eric, who is in a loveless relationship with a materialistic
I feel you, Eric.
Lynette.
Fucking. Are you sure I didn't write this? I smell sounds hauntingly familiar.
He starts cheating on his girlfriend with a more creatively supportive woman, Nadia.
Well, I gotta meet her. Where's the Nadia?
There's your summer girlfriend.
Summer Nadia is Nadia.
Nadia?
Yeah, I think Nadia is spelled with an A.
All right.
Both Lynette and Nadia play the double jackpot, the largest payout in lotto history, much like the recent Powerball. Both girls play his birth date as the winning numbers. Eric is now stuck between two of the country's richest women. Who will he choose? It's not that simple. This is a clever fucking idea,
yeah,
man.
Is.
Look at her. Fucking, she's impressed.
I am.
She got some summer reading. Christopher Colon smells real lovely with an original idea. This is. I've never heard this before.
I haven't either. This is a self-published book, much in the indie spirit as Kev's Clerks.
Oh, you don't even need to name check me. This is just a good idea. You could stand on your own, man. You don't even have to be like, hey, remember Clerks? This is nothing like that. This is way more original than Clerks. This is a good idea, man. Why didn't I think of this?
I need something to read. This book is part of the Comic Books, Heavy Metal, Video Games Trilogy Book 2. Odd I See, A Tale from the Road, coming soon.
Right on, man. It's part of a trilogy. This is the first part.
Way to write, man.
He's seeking a literary agent. Motherfuckers, anybody out there? There ain't no literary agents listening to this show, I assure you, sure. Sure, I assure you, sure. But somebody know a literary agent? Hook a motherfucker up! Chris Colon come up with an original idea. I should tell Raskin, that's a good fucking idea, to be honest with you. That's a fucking rom-com right there. Megan, get Raskin on the phone. Isn't it possible to get Raskin on the phone? No?
Yeah.
I want to run it past him, man. I want to, and if it happens, I get a taste, Chris Colon. I get a whiff, if you will.
The book could also be ordered on www.fmg.com. LULU.com.
That's Lulu.com.
I understand that. I just want to spell it out.
Normally one says it, that spells it. Still, Lulu.com. What is that? Do you know what it is?
I don't know. All right. The book could also be ordered on www.lulu.com. Search for Double Jackpot Christopher Cologne. A paperback version of the book is $15, and a PDF file is only $5.
$5 is insanely inexpensive. $15 is not even that bad for a paperback version.
No.
This is a $1 million idea right here. Like a fucking movie about a dude who fucking is stuck between two chicks, both of who play his birthday and win the lottery. Come on!
I
can see that trailer. Chris Cologne is on to something. Nobody else can smell it but me.
I'll read it.
Thank you. I'm going to make that smelly joke.
I know. You're trying to get me to laugh again.
It worked once. Double Jackpot is a self-published book by Chris Cologne, man. It's the first book in his comic books, heavy metal, video games trilogy. Book 2, Odd I See, A Tale from the Road, should be coming out soon. Get all the information at Chris Cologne, like a motherfucker.
Read this.
Double Jackpot. I'm serious. I'm going to recommend that to fucking Raskin. How is that not a movie? You know what I'm saying? This could be a sexy movie. You could do an R-rated version. There could be nudity in it, and you could sell them fucking both chicks. Maybe a little penetration. Maybe a butthole shot. No butthole, no care.
I would like to formally apologize to Christopher Cologne.
Sex sells. Chris Cologne will appreciate that. He's like, thanks for throwing a few buttholes in there, man.
Don't forget to check out twostrangersonepodcast.net, your one-stop resource for everything show-related. You can find links to subscribe to us on iTunes or on Stitcher. You could also find links to buy my book, Double Jackpot, on twostrangersonepodcast.net.
Fuck you, fuck you, fuck you. You're cool. And fuck you, I'm out.